Hi, my name is Stacy Adams, and I'm a speech-language pathologist at Sunshine Cottage School for Deaf Children in San Antonio, Texas. Today I get to share with you the electronic version of the Cottage Acquisition Scales for Listening, Language, and Speech, also known as the eCASLs. The CASLs are informal developmental checklists that track the development of listening, language, and speech skills from birth through 8 years of age. Although originally designed to use with students who are deaf or hard of hearing, the CASLs are a wonderful tool to use with any student working towards receptive and expressive language development, as well as articulation skills. Once logged in, you'll find your organization here. The My Students tab shows the students who are directly on your caseload. Organization administrators tend to be principals, supervisors, or department heads. Organization administrators can add and manage CASLs users and read-only users. They can also add and manage students within the organization and assign students to read-only users, CASLs users, and other organization administrators. An organization administrator has the ability to view and edit the student profile and student CASLs for any student within the organization. CASLs access users tend to be teachers, speech-language pathologists, or any other professional working directly with the child on listening, language, or articulation goals. A user with CASLs access can view and edit the student profile and CASLs for the students on their caseload. A person with read-only access can view but not edit the student profile and CASLs for students assigned to them. The read-only option is great for parents so they can see their child's progress and goals at any given point in time. It's also convenient to give read-only access to other professionals working with the student who may benefit from the information provided but don't necessarily need to edit goals or progress. Here you can find a list of all of the students within the organization. Using the search function makes finding a specific student quick and easy. The Settings tab lets you set the settings for your organization. The mastery threshold automatically defaults to 75%, but can be changed for the specific needs of your organization. Clicking the pencil icon lets you change the title for the color as well as select an end date. The CASLs uses a different color for each year in order to easily see the progress made during that time period. Let's take a look at a specific student profile. At the top of the screen, you'll see the demographic information for the student. Here you'll be able to see their primary CASLs level as well as any other CASL they may be working towards goals on. Their primary functioning level is stated here. You're able to edit the modes of communication, providing a primary mode of communication as well as secondary information. The notes area lets you make any notes that are relevant for the student. The listening age is automatically calculated based on the date of birth and the dates of amplification. Here you're able to see the student's degree of hearing loss, as well as when they received the different types of amplification, as well as whether it was for the left side or the right side. To edit a student profile, click on the pencil icon next to their name. Here you can provide their demographic information, as well as the information for their mode of communication and their audiological history. There's also a notes area provided at the bottom to provide any other information that's relevant for the student. Here, you can view the history of all of the professionals working with the student, as well as their access level. The analytics portion of the student profile is intended to give a snapshot of a student's progress on the eCASLs. All of the analytics are calculated off of the mastered column on the language CASLs. The analytics data is calculated against the mastery level threshold set by the organization. In many cases, it might be 75% or 80%. The dots represent where the student has met the mastery threshold for each specific CASLs domain. At a quick glance, the graph shows areas of relative strength and areas of needed improvement. The orange dotted line shows the student's primary functioning level. The primary functioning level is the highest functioning level at which the student has achieved the mastery level threshold, calculated as a percentage across all domains on a CASELS level. The analytics bar graph shows progress by each domain and functioning level on each level of the CASELS. For example, these are the functioning levels and domains of the simple sentence level of the CASELS. This measure is calculated as the percentage of mastery level goals achieved for each domain at each functioning level. Measures below 50% appear in orange. Measures above 50% but below the mastery level threshold appear in yellow. Measures at or above the mastery level threshold appear in turquoise. Additional information about the analytics can be found in the information section. Also, the student's profile and analytics can easily be printed. Let's take a look at the language CASELS. The language CASELS will automatically open to the student's primary CASELS level. You can change the CASELS level you're looking at by selecting the CASELS level arrow. You're also able to look at specific domains, specific functioning levels, and also to look at specific goals or notes. If you're looking for a specific structure, you're able to type the structure into the search section and hit apply. This makes looking for specific structures very easy and convenient on the electronic version of the CASELS. CASELS targets can be achieved at three levels: emerging, mastered, or generalized. Analytics are derived from the information provided in the mastered column only. Information icons are provided for each target and provide an explanation and example uses of the target. Therapy ideas, as well as carryover activities, are also provided. The information offered here can easily be printed and shared with the caregivers or used in therapy planning. You also have the ability to mark all targets for a particular domain and functioning level as achieved by selecting the Mark All as Achieved button. This is particularly helpful when beginning a CASELS with a new student. You are able to edit the boxes by clicking on the pencil icon in the top right corner of the box. Here, you can track the number of times you have observed the student use a particular target. This is helpful when determining if a student has achieved mastery of the target. If the student uses the target spontaneously without intervention, you can mark the target as achieved at evaluation. Doing so will place an X in the box. Selecting Yes under Make This a Goal will place a dot in the box. Once the student has achieved the target, you're able to place a date achieved into the box. The dot that was previously in the box will be replaced with the achieved date. You are able to keep track of the specific words the student uses by adding them here. You can also keep track of how many times the student uses each of these individual words. For CASELS targets with bolded target words, the target words are automatically populated so that the teacher or therapist can easily track the number of times the target is observed. There is also an area to make specific notes if needed. Make sure to click Save in order to save your changes. The eye in the box lets you know the number of times that particular target has been observed. The notes icon in the top left of the box lets you know that a note has been saved for that target. Don't forget that you can easily view and print your students' goals here. You can hang them in the classroom or send them home with carryover activities for parents and caregivers. Using this view is also particularly helpful when creating or updating IEPs. Now let's take a look at the speech castles. The speech castles allows you to track a student's articulation development from vocalizations through the use of final complex clusters. It also tracks the development of sounds from isolation through conversational speech. The functionality of the speech castles is the same as the language castles. The speech castles also has a built-in informal speech evaluation. Click on the picture icon in the bottom left corner to access pictures to elicit target sounds. Use the check mark and X to note correct and incorrect speech productions. After completing the target words, a pop-up will appear so that you can appropriately mark speech sounds as mastered or select appropriate goals. Once the goals are selected, you can view and print the goals here. Thank you for taking the time to familiarize yourself with the electronic version of the castles. We look forward to hearing about your experiences, as well as how you're able to incorporate the e-castles into your organization.